line where we've got to draw a line. Mm-hmm. See, we got to recognize the power that's invested in us. Why do you think so many people is getting shot in this city? Because we're not taking authority. We're not doing it. Now, I'm not saying all of us. I'm saying some of us. We're not taking authority. Why do you think storms and stuff comes in a city? We're not taking authority. You speak that. I have went out on my porch and pointed up to the sky. I said, you ain't coming here. This is my city. You ain't coming in my city. There's going to go Nickersville somewhere. It sounds silly. Now, I'm not talking about Nickersville. But if you're a Christian, stand on your power. Guys, that must be your city. Stand on it. Stand on it. Point up at the sky and say, yeah. See, I don't have no control over there. I can control where
right here,
where I live. Don't, this is my city.
Right.
You ain't turned my city up, but I can't speak for your city. That's you.
Hey.
You see what I'm saying?
He spoke to the wind and the way he said, peace be still.
That's what he said. And there were comments.
See, all that stuff sounds silly. But we got to practice using the authority that he has given us.
Yes.
Man, I tell you, see, I don't get into murder pictures and all that. I don't get into involved with that because I refuse to let the devil rob my faith. Mm-hmm. I refuse to let him do it. I have everything that I want. Mm-hmm. And I ain't bragging. It's a fact. Mm-hmm. I'm serious. I'm serious. I don't care how you look at me. I know what's mine.
Yes.
And I tell you, the power that Jesus gave me is mine. It is mine. Well, it's ours, but I'm claiming it for myself.
Right.
I ain't eating y'all out, but I think, you know, you don't want it, here's the man.
Exactly.
You know, it sounds silly. But when I read Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, it makes me wonder and just in awe of what he has invested in me.
Amen.
When Jesus went to the cross, he did it just for me.
Yeah.
Kitty Cora, yeah. He is skipping here.
Mrs. Shaggy.
One of the things, a few years ago, everybody knows I had gotten diagnosed with having seizures. Just a few years ago, about 4 years ago, God healed me of that as well. My neurologist released me from all medications then. I'm not taking anything for nothing, thank God.
Amen.
But I'm going to tell you what really inspired my healing. I kept praying for everybody else's healing.
That's good. Oh, yes.
Even though they had no reason why I was having those, there was no other than one significant thing. But there was no like diseases or medical issues or anything like that that was causing it to happen. So when I listened to what my doctor said, even when I didn't want to, followed his directions, mm-hmm. and I got released from all medication. But in the process of that, I kept praying for everybody else's healing.
Oh, yeah.
And because I was unselfish, God healed me. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And
but
I thank him for that.
You know, sister. One of the downfalls to a lot of believers is believe because we're suffering with the situation, mm-hmm. we don't have the power to do what God has called us to do.
Mm-hmm.
See,
but I kept on pressing towards the money. I'm determined.
Yeah.
Come hell or high water, I'm going to serve my God.
That's it. That's it.
I'm going to serve him. I don't care what the devil was trying to say. I don't care what the devil was trying to do.
Right.
I didn't care what the devil was trying to afflict. If God said he was going to heal me, I was going to stand
and that's
the word
right.
and decree that thing over my life. I didn't care what the enemy said.
Right.
If we made a little lower than the angels, then I'm going to speak what he has given inside of me to speak. Mm-hmm. And if he said we got the same power he got, I'm going to speak that thing
that's
over
it.
My life.
Yes,
and I didn't speak. Nativity has a way of coming to fruition of people's lives because you keep speaking and speaking and speaking and speaking and speaking and speaking. And then you wonder why you have that issue. But if you reverse that thing and start speaking some positive and start speaking what the Word of God says, watch the Word of God take effect in your life. Don't just speak with negative, 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 and then you don't have no results. You're not going to have results. But you keep speaking what the Word says.
Yeah.
The Word of God said he will not return to him void, but accomplish the purpose that which he has set that out to do.
Yep.
Yeah. He said a thing, he's going to create a thing, he's going to do a thing, he's going to establish a thing. You just got stand on it.
Yeah, that's it. Yes, ma'am.
And I found out too, through the sickness and everything, is that remaining faithful to God.
And continue to press.
Yes. I mean,
that's right.
Nobody knows probably what, you know, Nighty went through, because Nighty was always pressed. He was here, you know. And even with my experience, short of bread, short winded, it didn't stop me from dirt and fire. It didn't stop me from doing praise and worship.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I would come, nobody knows when my legs were broke out real bad. I would have to run home in between service, take care of that, run back to church. Because I did not let it slow me down.
Yeah.
I was refusing to let it slow me down. You know what I'm saying?
Amen.
So, and I'm not saying, I'm not knocking nobody else, don't get me wrong.
Yeah.
But I had that desire to continue on and doing what I was doing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes. Yeah.
Standing up, legs in pain, aching, you know what I'm saying? I mean, my legs were broke out, so singing, you know, I mean, literally broke out real bad. Go home, pantyhose changing them. I mean, had to go through it, pulling them. You know, I went through.
Wow.
Nice, excruciating pain to the point where I thought I had to go to the doctor, you know. It was just crazy. And y'all know my cough, which y'all know. Y'all experienced all of that. But in the midst of all that, I was determined.
Amen.
Continuous, I had that desire in me.
Yes.
Tired, no energy. Couldn't even, you know, sometimes it would take me so much to just get up in the morning and bathe. Before I can get my clothes on, I'd have to go lay down. Had no energy. But in the midst of all that, and walking to work, walking home, at the hotel, I said, go give me strength, get to my car, go give me strength. Constantly, I just kept on praying, kept on trusting God, and kept on pressing.
Yes.
And then I'll continue in what he has assigned me to do.
Yes.
You know, I didn't use that as a crush to not do.
Yeah.
You know, I can't do it, I can't be there. You know, I continue, because that was my desire, that's my love for him. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
What comes, if I can get there, if I can continue doing it, gonna do it. And I believe through all that, through our faith with God on the day.
Yes. 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 Exactly. Yes, ma'am.
Mother Ross, she has a saying that if you be faithful to God, he'll be faithful to you.
I believe. Yeah.
I just made that girl go take somebody to my job. You know, sometimes I work on me, sometimes I don't. She said, now I'm coming into a Christian salon. But we got to talk, and she said, you know what, we got to learn how to wait on God. I mean, she just ministered to me like, no other. I thank God for who's talking about this. We're talking about being faithful to God and waiting on God and, you know, just his time.
Yeah, yeah.
He does that.
Yeah.
Faithfulness.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank God, what Sister Teresa said, in other words, perseverance, even doing that takes me back to our parents and ancestors.
Yes, right.
They pressed their way no matter what was. So I think, you know, with that, you know, we learn with them.
Yes.
Amen.
So for some of us, that same, you know,
yeah.
You feel bad, but, you know, it's pressing somewhere.
Yeah.
You know, if you feel like you want to give up,
just
think about failing, and that just kind of encourages
you. Yeah.
Exactly. It's hard. Exactly. Exactly.
Have you ever had something up to that? For example, I know I have to translate first, and it takes a little minute trying to. So, for example, my mother was sick of cancer.
Mm-hmm.
And guys, I heard that on a Thursday morning. Thursday afternoon, my little legs went to church. No one's church on Thursday afternoon but me. Like, I didn't care what day of the week it was. I needed to go to the sanctuary because I was fresh into my, you know, Pentecostal movement. I didn't think that I had any power to do it from my car, from home. I had to go to him.
Mm-hmm.
So I went to church, and the you know, pastor's wife, she's playing on the piano, blah, blah, blah. She said, what are you doing? I'm crying, I'm praying, I'm desperate. And I said, Mama is being diagnosed, and I think she's not that. And so I prayed and I prayed, and I couldn't pray anymore. I mean, I just talked. I just fell asleep. And because I kept praying when I go. She said, you know, you don't have to pray here. Of course, she tells me you can pray.
Right.
Well, me, I didn't know. So Mama was healed the first time, temporarily healed. She had 16 months therapy, chemo, surgery, name it, got it, torture, all of it, to be healed for 16 or 18 months. Very short period of time. Cancer comes back. And when it comes back, it comes to kill. It doesn't come to forgive or to, you know, whatever. Bishop, I didn't pray. I gave for granted that my mother was going to be healed again. But did I think that? I didn't. I was just living in my momentum. I had children with me. I had my brothers and sisters. We're six people here. None of them told me my mother was deathly sick again. I took the call from the doctor who said, oh, we got chemo to do, we got work to do, because I told him immediately, is this it? Is this it, doctor? He said, no, honey, we got work to do, absolutely not. This was 3 days before Christmas. Mama passed January 15th. Mm. Okay? There's work to do.
Yeah.
They had a meeting with the doctor, I wasn't there. So many little things that I think afterwards, mm-hmm. Sisters, brothers don't tell me that Mama's got just a week or two. They still kept doing chemo, killed her faster. I wasn't there physically, spiritually, in prayer, nothing. I was just there before she passed. And you know what? I sit afterwards. This is what I call aftermath. Mm-hmm. And I kept telling people, I didn't pray that the second time. I thought he was going to give that to me.
Now, go back to what Emma said. Because what happened was the second time, you took your guard down.
Yeah.
And by we gotta be careful of complacency. Yeah. Right? Complacency is very dangerous.
Bad. It's a bad spot.
Yes,
yes, it is.
It's very bad.
Lord Jesus.
We gotta constantly be regularly in prayer and all the elements that the spiritual walk takes, we cannot take no downtime. Mm-hmm. Cannot take any downtime. Because the devil wants us to take downtime. Mm. I remember the words of the late Bishop Ross would say, he said, when you let your guard down, he's coming. Mm. And he's coming back, and he's coming back with more force.
More healing, man.
And so, and I'm glad you kind of mentioned that, because it's up to us as believers to never take our guard down. Never be, I'm using a term people used to say, never be at ease in Zion. And when I speak in the church, never let your guard down. What it took to get where you're at, what it took to do what it's going, you're going through, you gotta keep it.
Come on.
And we gotta be like people in sports. You gotta do it with more momentum. Mm-hmm. More momentum.
Yeah.
I'm gonna give you an example. First time last year, and some of you can relate to this, the Golden State Warriors got beat last year by the Cleveland Cavaliers. Mm-hmm. Watch this. This year, this season.
I believe you, I don't know.
take my word.
I don't need to take your word.
This season.
We are.
Golden State said, we're not going to lose this year. They're coming back this season with more momentum. They're not going to allow what beat them last year, beat them this year. They come with more energy. More everything. And they're literally mastering the Cleveland Cavaliers.
Well, I guess it's defeat or the reflection of it that is making me learn from. Because, I mean, even when I tell my sister, you know, something like that, she'd be like, oh, don't beat yourself up. Yeah, I do. Because even if I did pray, God would have responded to me in a different way. With faith that even if Mama was living, it's because she needed the rest. Or, you know, you just get the peace of mind and say, God knows best. God always answers. He may not give you what you want, but he always answers.
But I'm saying what I said is that we have to still keep momentum.
I know.
God is in control.
Yes.
But we still keep momentum.
Yes.
Because if we look at the life of Christ, as go in the wilderness, he kept momentum. And the Bible says that after those three turn times, he said, the Bible says that then Satan left him only for a season. And so, in those, I call them calm moments or times, we can't be calm. We gotta have more momentum. Because the whole time he is calm, he's thinking something to trip us up. Worse than the other time. And so that's why we got to be with momentum. I keep this word momentum. We got to keep this momentum going with more momentum. Yeah.
Bishop, I understand what you're saying.
Yeah, I do.
Because the Lord spoke to me one day and told me to anoint Jeannie.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought in my heart that everything's all right. You know, that settles it. God said do it, I done it, that settled it. And when they told me that she passed, that knocked me out of my chair. Because I didn't see that.
Right.
Lord didn't tell me to pray. He didn't tell me to, and I did that. I did. And left everything alone. I didn't do nothing else.
She said that word for you.
And then all of a sudden, I got hot. And I said, no.
Yep. Yep, sir.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. This is good. I was worried about it.